I met Jane Horrocks at the outset of my career in London, commissioned to photograph her several times by numerous publications. We became firm friends, and it seems we experimented with certain ideas, icons, and dress-ups. Marilyn Monroe was one of them, not only for the poses, but for the sexy singing too. Jane and I would go to clubs in Brixton, eat cheap chicken and chips in fry-up joints, giggle a lot. I accompanied her to the first filming of Absolutely Fabulous at the Beeb, to the premiere of The Rise and Fall of Little Voice. This was all before the altered world of husbands and babies. The 90s came to pass. The digital revolution was in full swing. 2008 crash had happened. By 2013, I was contemplating the fact and the mystery of occasional unemployment, earning a living, and the notion of compromise and following one's real passion. The time on my hands, I began to page through the scrapbooks that I had kept in the 1990s, which contained those letters, postcards, and faxes. I realized people were communicating differently due to the new technology. I was still friends with those that I'd photographed. Some of them. I had photographed Simon Curtis, the producer, and Jane Horrocks together. Jane Horrocks and I now texted when we wanted to meet or chat, and Simon Curtis and I were Facebook friends. I texted them both and asked who they would choose now, all these years later. Who would their affinity be? Jane said that she'd choose her son. Simon Curtis said he'd choose Jolie Richardson or Hugh Bonneville. Later, they both changed their mind. Jane Horrocks said, my co-student Serena Gordon at RADA. Have a sleep. Maybe I can just... The other thing you could do is, Jane, show me how the kids today are singing.
I don't know what I am doing here.
Oh, God.
But in life, we don't know much.
Simon Curtis said, having thought about it, can I be photographed with Hugh Bonneville and Elizabeth McGovern? We have a wife in common. Later, Jane said, can I be photographed with you as well? And so the new series of Affinities was born.